In this video, we will discuss who is responsible for collecting data on the Consumer Price Index, and we will work through a mathematical example of how the CPI is calculated. Once we calculate the CPI for different years, we can measure inflation, which is the rate of change in the CPI between periods of time. The government organization responsible for reporting inflation numbers is the Bureau of Labor Statistics. If that name sounds familiar, it's because it's the same organization that reports the unemployment numbers. The BLS is responsible for defining what the typical consumer spends their money on. They use that information to create what we call a basket of goods. The BLS uses and tracks the cost of that basket of goods to see how the cost of living changes for the typical consumer. There are a couple of things that you are probably asking yourself. What do we mean by a typical consumer? The BLS defines a typical consumer as an individual that is part of an urban family of four. The other question that you're probably asking yourself is, how do we define this basket of goods? To find out what people buy most often, the Bureau of Labor Statistics surveys families and individuals each year. Roughly 7,000 families from around the country report information on their spending habits on a quarterly basis. The BLS then creates a basket of 8,000 goods and services that represent what the family purchases. These products fall in 211 different consumer goods categories. The BLS collects data from 38 geographic regions in the United States. This figure shows what the typical family spends their money on. As you can see, that your spending might not reflect the spending of a typical family. Therefore, CPI and inflation might not reflect changes in your true cost of living. Now that you know how the BLS selects the basket of goods, let's see how they use it to calculate CPI and eventually inflation. In this example, we will simplify our products from 8,000 to 3. Let's assume that the average consumer basket has the following goods: TV streaming service, clothing, burritos. Also, let's assume that we only have 2 years of data, 2015 and 2016. The basket of goods and services that the consumer purchases is 12 units of TV streaming, 20 units of clothing, 365 units of burritos. Now that we know the basket of goods, we need the price of each good in 2015. The price of TV streaming service is $10. Clothing is priced at $45 each, and burritos at a price of $7 each. The final step is to calculate the total expenditure on the basket of goods for 2015. To do that, we will calculate the total expenditure on TV streaming by multiplying the quantity by price. That's 12 times 10. The total expenditure on TV streaming is $120. Let us repeat the same thing for clothing. That will be 20 by 45. The total expenditure on clothing in 2015 is $900. Burritos cost $7 each, and the basket includes 365 units. The total expenditure is $2,555 on burritos. We sum expenditure on each of these goods and calculate our total expenditure. Our expenditure on the entire basket of goods is $3,575. To convert this to an index, meaning CPI, we need to use the following equation. The price index is equal to the expenditure on the basket in the current year divided by the expenditure in the base year, then we multiply that by 100. For this example, we do not have the expenditure on the base year. So let us assume that 2010 is the base year and the expenditure on the basket during that year was $3,400. To calculate CPI for 2015, take the expenditure for 2015, which is $3,575, divided by the expenditure in the base year, which was $3,400, and multiply it by 100. The CPI for 2015 is 105.15. The base year CPI will always be 100.
Let us move on to calculating the CPI for 2016. We know the basket of goods. Let us see what the prices are for 2016 for each of the goods. TV streaming prices increased to $12. Clothing is now $40 each, and burritos are $10. Remember that the basket remains constant. Only prices are changing from year to year. Total expenditure on TV streaming will be 12 times 12, or $144. Expenditure on clothing is 20 by 40, or $800. Burrito spending is now 365 by 10, or $3,650. The total expenditure for 2016 is $4,594. To calculate the CPI, we divide the expenditure of the current year by the expenditure of the base year and multiply it by 100. That's 4,594 divided by 3,400 multiplied by 100, which is 135.12. The CPI in 2016 is 135.12. Now we have the CPI for 2015 and the CPI for 2016. The CPI in 2015 was 105.15, and in 2016 it was 135.12. We can calculate the inflation rate between the 2 years, which is simply the growth rate of CPI. We will use YT minus 1 divided by YT minus 1 multiplied by 100 to measure the growth rate. YT is the CPI from 2016, which is 135.12. YT minus 1 is the CPI from 2015, which is 105.15. So that's 135.12 minus 105.15, which is equal to, and then divide that by YT minus 1, which is 105.15. An inflation rate of 28.50%.
That's how the calculation is done. Obviously, our example made this seem very easy by simplifying the basket from 8,000 goods to 3. But now you have an idea how CPI and inflation are calculated. In future lessons, we will discuss how to use CPI and inflation in your everyday life. We'll also talk about some limitations of CPI as a measure of cost of living. As a recap, in this video, we talked about the BLS and how they define the basket of goods and services, how they collect data on prices of the basket. We also did a mathematical example of how to calculate CPI, and once we have CPI for multiple years, how to calculate inflation rates. Make sure to practice some of the problems that I've provided you. If you need any help, reach out. See you next class.